Hello there everybody, how's it going? I'm Voiding Am Duty Legends commentary today. Don't know why I screwed up my intro so badly. I guess it's just because I'm possessed or something. Let's look at the teams. Hello there everybody, how's it going? I am Voiding Am Duty Legends commentary today, and today I am playing as LeBlernk in the mid lane. Let's take a look at the teams here. We have Kha'Zix jungle, Vayne AD carry, Malphite top, LeBlanc mid, Bard support. They have Trundle support, Yasuo mid, I think. Gameplank top, Ashe AD carry with Ignite, funnily enough, and then Diana in the jungle. It's possible it's Gameplank mid and Yasuo top, but I'm just going to go on a limb and say it's probably Yasuo mid, who will probably be annoying to deal with because of his wind wall, which of course can block both my E and my Q. So I'm going to have to play my card. It's a bit early to rapidly paint someone. Jeez, people. Look, it's soy twattle twattle twattle. Just let the guy live his life the way he wants to live his life and everything will be just fine. I'll admit, a bit skeptical about how this game's gonna go, mainly because of Kha'Zix and Bard. I mean, I know the Bard personally, so I don't necessarily think it's... I'm thinking bot lane will go okay. I think it mostly depends on if I ganked a lot, but Kha'Zix is kind of a rare... I mean, he's a weak champion right now, so... I'm kind of concerned to see what he'll do, because while you can get fed as him, it's really hard to really do a whole lot in terms of actual damage, so I don't really know. We'll see, though. Apparently, Vayne didn't know what she was doing, but I didn't actually see what happened, so we'll just, not get involved in this conversation, just go in our mid lane, have a grand old time. So, there's the Yasuo right there, so just go and immediately throw a Q in his face. Actually, might have not been in a great idea, considering his winch wall pretty much just... got rid of it. We'll throw another Q at him though. I may actually want to save my Q mana for my W, because my Q by itself doesn't do a whole lot of damage, but with the W it kind of does. And of course, LeBlanc does have decent mana issues in the early game, so want to be a little bit watchful of that. Minions, stop firing at me! Oh my god, they won't let up! Jiminy Christmas, just leave me alone, minions, okay? Just gotta learn to calm down, you gotta learn when it's not your time to shine anymore, and this is very much not your time to shine, okay, minions? Thank you. Glad we had this conversation. Okay, so we'll throw ahead, do some damage there. There's the W, and he got a crit off! He got a crit off this early in the game. That is bull patootie if I ever heard or ever saw one. So that's RNG not really working in my favor. I'm not happy about it. First blood, though. Already in our bot lane, so that's pretty good. And we'll almost get a kill. Oh, I'm dead. Alright, well, at least I'm pretty sure I could have gotten a kill there without dying myself, but I kind of screwed up and just walked too close to him. If I just was a little bit patient and waited for my spells to go back up, I'm pretty sure I could have just, like, flash ignite and use my QW and whatnot, but... sadly, that is not what we did, which is a disappointment, of course, but something we should be able to live through. I will go ahead and buy a Fairy Charm, and I'll buy another Health Potion, because he does seem to be a little bit spooky. But, you know, when a kill is a kill, and excitement is excitement regardless, and I'm okay with this. I'm also very okay with the fact that we got a kill off on the Ashe that early, and that was very early. I'm guessing Bard got a stun off on Ashe at level... because I saw Ashe was level 1, and then maybe Vayne was able to get a condemn off? I'm not entirely sure. I am not entirely sure. Our CS, though, is not looking too good, and looks like also a kill going down to the Malphite. So some good things looking for our team right now. Our experience in comparison to Yasuo is not looking too ideal. Oh my god, oh, you've gotta be kidding me! His flippin' wind thing stopped my W mid-flight. I am so mad now. That just screwed me up so badly. Not only did I miss the E. Alright, well. How I was talking about how Yasuo might be an annoying lane? He isn't going to be an infuriating lane, apparently. The fact that his knock-up thing actually stops my W in its tracks does not please me one bit. I am going to level up my... that was bad. I am going to level up my W first, because of the fact that he can't block that with his wind wall. So that seems like the best course of action here. He is not level 5 yet. I want, of course, to get rid of his windshield. Alright, there's his wind wall. I'm perfectly fine with that being gone. Go and throw that right there and then do this. That'll be some decent damage. Oh, and there's a Diana. Hello, Diana. Unlikely she's going to really be able to get much of a gank off on me, but looks like she is trying. That is something to keep in mind. Looks like Kazakh is also playing to gank a certain game plank. Get it? Gank a certain game plank. It's a joke. It's not really a good joke, though. God, this guy's really not giving me an easy time. I'm not going to lie. And now it's just because of my mana issues, I'm not really going to be able to do much to him. So that's a bit of a concern, but we should be fine as time goes on. I'm not really concerned, again, I'm not really concerned about dying in lane, just because my W exists, but we're definitely not going to be getting a kill with how much we're using our mana. It's just so hard to actually land my combo on him. And I didn't really foresee that being that much of an issue, and now he's just dashing in on me and being a big old nuisance, and I kind of wish he would just stop. Nah, I just really kind of wish he would just cut it out, leave me alone. I wish we could talk it over some tea, but you know, Yasuo doesn't seem really that fond of the whole tea idea. So let's just go ahead and let him take those turret shots. Fine by me. Pop a Q right there, and I'll have my ignite up soon. But he very well might try to dive me regardless. Because of course I only have enough mana for one summoner spell. Didn't think I'd be playing a defensive LeBlanc game today, but you know, that stuff kind of happens. You know, you never know when you might just go against some random Yasuo flipping spins a tornado at you, and then you just fly up in the air as you're midway through your distortion. It's just like, well, this is not pleasant. And then Yasuo's like, I know that. That's why I did it. And then you're like, well, you're actually the worst thing of all time. And then he's like, that's kind of rude, dude. And the conversation just continues, and no one wonders why or asks why it continues. It just does. I like to tell you that there was a meaning behind everything I just said. There really wasn't, though. Alright. At least I'm getting some mana back ever so slowly with my Doran's Ring. And you know, this is, if once we get enough mana, and maybe we can get a gank, then we might be able to get a kill. Though Kazakh will probably have to gank from, like, over there or something, which doesn't look like he's planning on doing that anytime soon. Be wary of him while he has his tornado thingy up. Yes, hello. Hello there, Yasuo, we'll have a good day. Pop this thingy and do this and do the double mimic, and that will be a kill. I want to make sure I get just enough autos off, and that will be the kill. There we go. It's good that I stayed long as I did, because that last auto was in fact what I need to ensure his demise. And he used his ignite as well, which worked out well for me. So saving up for the mana actually worked. Took a while, but it worked. And because of this, I am satisfied with my performance. Let's go and just get the components for my Namakan. I'm actually going to buy 2 health potions. I'm actually just going to buy 1 health potion, 1 mana potion. I don't want to spend too much money on potions because, of course, I want to kind of get my items more quickly so I can make more good things happen in the world. And, you know, if I stop to get potions, you know, that progress is going to be halted. And no one wants that. Literally no one wants that. I just threw my hands up in the air to signify that. No one can see it, but they were flailing, it was great. Okay, don't quote me on anything I just said. Alright, so do some damage to this fella right here. There's the Thanamabob, and let's go put another one right there, and that will be a kill. Kazakh's gonna swipe him in the face, which will result in a kill. So Yasuo, now 1-3. And you can tell this Yasuo isn't that bad. In fact, he's pretty decent, but like, I played Yasuo early today, and it's just so hard to do well with him, I've tended to find. Like, you can make pretty cool plays in the early game, but actually, like, gain something out of the cool plays tends not to happen that often. Unless you're really skilled with him. Which, you know, it's a shame that Yasuo's kind of in that rut now of really, really bad early game. And, you know, as I was saying, Kazakh may not be a good champion, but this Kazakh is... No, he's doing work anyway. In fact, our entire team's doing pretty well for themselves, which I'm quite happy about. Heck, and since the ashes ignite, we can probably roam and get some things done. Oh my god. Alright, I'm just gonna... That chain flippin' missed. That chain really looked like it hit. You can tell I'm not exactly a pro LeBlanc player. Oh well. Weren't in any danger of dying, but we are gonna have to go back because of how poorly I executed my moves there. So we can get our Namakan now. Can't get my boots, sadly enough, so I'll just buy a singular potions deck, because I always like to have at least one. I don't know why, it's just a thing I, you know, have. Maybe to help ward off an ignite, things of that general nature. Is going to do some decent amount of damage to the turret. Oh, and Diana is there as well. Going to throw a ping there and help Kha'Zix. Tries to help. They're not going to get it, but they definitely want to get a lot of damage off, which is an interesting move. That's not. I was hoping Yasuo would get baited and going on the Kha'Zix there, but sadly he did not. He's probably, you know, he's a bit smarter than that. He probably, granted, he was probably in vision. Let's ignore that slight detail that he was probably in vision and just pretend that psychic force told him of who was coming. Also, there might be a Yasuo as well as a Diana. It's a slight possibility. Yeah, there's the Diana. That's gonna be going in the Bard, and there's the Bard ultimate. But that will be the dead Bard by the looks of it, and I really don't know if I'm gonna be able to help at that point. If I was really good at Diana, I would feel comfortable about maybe roaming there, but we're not gonna take that chance. Dang it, Yasuo. Show yourself back in my lane, good sir. I want to make good things happen in this world, especially since my CS is kind of abysmal, so I really need me some kills, and if you're gonna kind of, you know, walk away from me, then I'm not gonna be able to get kills, and then no one's happy. So that's actually gonna be our bot turret going down. Not too great, but, you know, at the end of the day, our Vayne is 2-0, while their Ashe is 0-2 with Ignite. I still don't know about the Ignite thing with Ashe. It seems really, really bad, but, you know, what am I saying? Alright, do some damage there. And then do some damage again here. Oh, he dodged it. I'm not going to be able to do much here. Oh, all right, Flash. All right. Do some damages there. Might have... It was a bit much. We let Vayne get a kill because of it. And they were all really low. But sadly, it was not enough. Okay, I really need boots. I'll get my Loon's Echo now. So a lot of people probably wonder why I didn't rush it. I really want the mana regen CDR. So we'll work on getting that now. I am going to sell a singular or my mana potion for an amplifying tome. And this might be the death of... Yeah, this is probably death of Kha'Zix here. He did at least get a kill prior to his demise. This is going to be his death, right? I don't think... I don't think Diana has enough mana for a Q. Yep, that will actually be no deaths there. That's very good news. Good job, Kha'Zix. His no death streak is staying alive. Meanwhile, I'm a feeder and I'm half the team's gosh dang deaths, so I'm just the worst, apparently. Kha'Zix, buddy, what were you doing? You were supposed to go back, yes! Okay. It's fine. Yasuo is no longer within that bush. This is okay. There's no point in teleporting back to that that distortion, but I thought I would anyway because, you know what? Why the heck not, right? You know, there comes a time in life where you have to make tough decisions. Agh! This is one of those tough times. Pay no attention to the Ram screen. It was, me releasing a belch, I think. I'm not entirely sure. It's very, very impolite of me, and I apologize, but, you know, sometimes those kind of things just happen. Usually crying occurs afterwards, but, you know, that's okay. We have a Bard nearby. Hello there, Mr. Bard. How are you doing today? He's going to throw a Health Shrine down. And yeah, so I actually scored a blue buff from the Kha'Zix. Okay. Alright, that apparently did go off, and that's also going to go off. This is so hard to deal with. I'm dead. Oh, I'm not dead. I'm Fatak. Gameplank, why? Why did you do this to me, Gameplank? I didn't ask for this. I'm not a complicated man. I don't ask for a lot. Well, then you have to flip and gum here and shoot your gosh dang cannons. That doesn't make me feel very good. And you know what, I'm not happy about it. I don't think anyone would be happy about it, but I'm especially not happy about it. Alright, it's okay. That's gonna be Bard doing the little secret there where it's not even in the wall, but, you know, it's kind of in the wall, but it's kind of isn't in the wall. There's gosh dang three people in my mid lane. I just want to flip and have peace with myself, but they are not allowing such. Maybe one day this peace will be... Oh, no. Please, people, I want my gold. I don't have any. I have 67 CS. It's not very prestigious. Granted, it's pretty much on par with most of them, so I guess it's not that bad in that regard. But, you know, still. We'll throw a Q on the Diana. Bit wary going on her. She might be able to burst this. That's four people top. Interesting strategy they're executing, but 4 by... I don't know what they're doing. It's an interesting method of doing things, and dang, we missed the CS because of that, my good friend. Alright. Hello there. Ash, we'll do some damage to you, and then we'll immediately throw a chain on this guy and get another kill. There we go. Fantastic. Immediately going in the Ash rather than the Diana because she was just that much more squishy, so I'll take the opportunity to get some kills and make my score look not as abysmal. You know, it's still... I've still made some abysmal plays, but let's be honest, the game plank and this Yasuo are making me quite upset. Okay, hello there. Hello there, Yasuo. How are you doing on this fine afternoon? I hope the answer is okay. Let's immediately make sure we don't get hit by the tornado and die. Because, you know, that very likely will happen considering what I've been doing this game. Hello. Oh, you were in range. Gosh dang it, Yasuo, get out of here. Okay. I'm not going to die by any means. I'm going to go back and get these large rod. As much as I would like to stay and get CS and or get Sorcerer's Shoes, the rod is just too tempting, so we will... Oh, no, I didn't mean to take the gosh dang portal! No, get me back over there. I do not want anything to do with this flipping, you know, lack of heals. I would like my health, and I would like it full, and I would like it pleasing. Alright, Mr. Yasuo, you may not be killing me a whole lot. Actually, I think he's killing multiple... I don't know where my deaths are from. One's from Gameplank. Looks good. Yasuo, he's being a nuisance. We must punish him. I was talking about earlier how it'd be pretty difficult to do things with Yasuo, and... Oh, the bard, though. Oh, my God. Ah, the combos. The combos, though. Let this guy just suffer. Oh, my. My distortion's not up. But, you know, someone's gonna have to try to get him. Yeah, hello there, buddy. Hello. We're gonna just kill you. You know, everyone else may have forgotten about you, but I did not. There's a slight problem, though, and it looks like our friends may have died while I was securing the kill on the Trundle. Let's see here. Hello. Hello there, Diana. Oh. Alright. Got a bit low there. Ah, okay. Careful. I'm worried. Ah, there's the yes. Any flash? Okay, he had his flash up. God diggity. That was not the best leap ever seen. Alright, yeah, I stayed too long. That's okay. God, I feel like I'm playing terribly. I don't know what the deal is with me. I can't just keep saying this Yasuo, though. That's not prestigious LeBlanc. We're Ravenborn LeBlanc. We gotta make good things happen. I think this is maybe part of the reason why LeBlanc isn't played as much anymore, is because she, you know, while she can be an assassin, it's also really easy to die as her. But, I mean, maybe I'm just saying that because I'm bad. In fact, that's probably the case, but hey. We're going to go in the middle lane, and we're going to make good things happen. The Diana is honestly the main concern, because she can burst me down before I can burst her down, which worries me. And they really want to go for that Ash, which will be very easily successful, because the Ash, again, is not really doing so well for herself. That is a Yasuo making things happen as well. Let's go ahead and just take that kill for ourselves, and then... Yeah, we're not gonna be able to get to him. Our distortion was on cooldown, sadly. Is the Gameplank gonna remain in the top lane? No, he isn't. That is gonna be a Gameplank ult, though. Almost, you know, almost gained the kill on the Kha'Zix, but not close enough. I guess no one's gonna stop the Gameplank. I was thinking Malphite would return to home base now, but it doesn't look like he wants to do that. So that will be a top turret going down for us. Let's see, this thing right there. Throw that right there, then throw another chain in that. No! Ignite! Okay. Okay, are we good? Good job, Kha'Zix. You just leaped like 10,000 times. That was spooky. Got hit by an arrow while I was stunned into the abyss. The chains might have not been the best opportunity, but that, you know, at the end of the day, it was all I had at that particular moment, so, you know, I had to use what I had. Noon's Echo is now ours. But next, we'll work on getting Zhonya's, because I'd see that being quite beneficial to me. And, you know, I'm quite far behind in terms of my boots. I still only have the level 1 boots, but, you know, at the end of the day, a lot of people do. Malphite has level 1 boots. Diana has level 1 boots. And Trundle has level 1 boots. So I am not the only one with level 1 boots. I am the one with level 2 boots and level 3 boots and level 5 boots. And then everyone's just like, oh my god, so many boots. That may not be entirely accurate. Alright, hello there. Hello there, good sir. I wish to use a chain on you and then flee as this gosh dang Ash is here, ruining my fun. Hello there, Malphite. Hello there, Yasuo, getting my revenge very easily. The damage is quite through the roof. I'm not going to be satisfied until my KD ratio starts to really, you know, alter its course. Oh, hello. Wait, who was that? That was Diana. I wish to speak with these good sirs, though it looks like they're just going to kind of vanish into nothingness. This is what happens when I open my big dumb mouth. Kazakhs is fed. Yasuo is doing well for himself in terms, at least in terms of how he's playing. Like, what even is life right now? I'm unsure. That's a blue buff that I would really, really like. So I'm going to go ahead and try my best to secure it for myself. I think the E, yeah, the E does work on it. So we'll just go ahead and get that nice and easy. Thank you very much, Kazakhs, for letting me have it. We'll go back now and get our Sorcerer's Shoes because, well, you know, plus I'm pretty low on health, so mine as well. My CS is 72. A whopping 72, ladies and gentlemen. You can hold your applause for later. Right now, we're busy accomplishing great goals and great tasks. Stop looking at that hourglass. Thank you. Good thing she listened to me, because otherwise, she was going to get hurt. Alright. Hello there, Gangplanku. How are you doing, good sir? Let's just go ahead and do lots of damage to you. Immediately destroy him with the double distortions, which will do a fair amount of damage, I will say. Yeah, stay away from me. That's a Bard ultimate. This is okay. I can handle a Bard ultimate. I can also handle doing that to score me some beautiful, beautiful balloons. So I can't hear the sound of that gaping hole between your legs is making. That's an interesting comment by Darth Inkleborg, ladies and gentlemen. You can, you know, frame that quote on your mantle if you want. I personally won't, but, you know, if you want some wise words from the wisest man there ever was, who is not him, then talk to, like, some professor. I don't know. Alright. There's an Ash. She will die. Because she's 0-9. Ash, what are you doing, buddy? I'm going to go on a limb and say their teams probably complain about Ash. But, you know, everyone has those games. But it's like, it comes to the point where it's like, I can't even say it's like you're having one of those games because you have Ignite, Ash. Like, you should never, ever have Ignite as an AD carry. That's just something you should know. Hello there, Trundle. Let's put a chain on you so we don't have to deal with you much longer. Then we'll go ahead and put the double thing right there. Doesn't do a whole lot of damage because, of course, my distortion is leveled up first. Do some more damage there and wait, what's going on? We're doing stuff, I believe. Let's put an ignite on this guy and then do this distortion, and that will be everyone's complete demises. Triple kill for the LeBlanc. I won't lie, I was considering stopping the recording because I was embarrassed in my early gameplay, but now we are getting things done! Oh my god. Oh my good grief. And then he just casually uses the spikes after missing his claw. That's pretty grand. Well, I'm going to go on a limb and say we'll probably have this game in the bag. I think I got like a 3-man distortion on them in that last fight, which worked very well for us. And can I just like... Okay, I can almost straight up get my Zhonya's. I would like to stay long enough to where I can straight up get my Zhonya's. Of course, it is a bit of a difficult task to accomplish. So, you know, we'll try. That's going to be that guy's wind wall going down. And let's go ahead and just immediately kind of be a little bit careful of this flat. I'm pretty sure Gangplank shot me. And it followed me a while and killed me. So that concerns me. Kind of makes me mad, to be honest. Kind of makes me very upset and ready to kill. Legendary? Oh, I thought one of them was legendary. I'm like, when did that happen? But that's okay. Might have stayed a bit long as well, but god damn, the flipping bullet followed me like 10,000 miles, and that, not very, balls of steel. Get it? It's a joke from Binding of Isaac Rebirth. If you get that, then that's good. It's actually just a pill name, but that's okay. Got our Zhonya's Hourglass, so we can finally have some sort of defensive capability aside from just being evasive. Grand, someone argued that you don't really need the Zhonya's and you can just go, should go Rabadons instead. But I think I do enough damage at this point, and at the end of the day, Zhonya still gives a lot of AP, so not feeling too bad about it. Next time, we'll probably go Rabadons, because I don't think any of them are actually building MR. No, they are not. I don't know why, but they are not. I guess because none of them are really just a tank in general. But even then, Trundle, yeah, none of them are building MR, so we're pretty much good. I'm going to place a ward over here. We can probably kill this Yasuo if we kind of catch him off guard in this bush, maybe. I'm not the type to camp, but let's go and just do some damage here, and that will be the chain, which will probably secure the kill. There we go. I was a bit worried, I'm not going to lie, but thankfully that will be his ultimate demise. I also could have Zonius man the chain on him. That's something I definitely should have done. That's okay, though. I'm going to play it safe and go back, and yeah, okay, they know I'm here. I was going to press my luck just a little bit, but not for that long. Oh, the Bard ultimate. I'm just in case I want to do a distortion. There we go, the double distortion. They immediately zone you so they can't focus me. And then do the QE there, and that will be a kill and fantastic stuff going down here. Let's just go and throw the Q off on that guy. And the triple kill for the 17-3 Kha'Zix. The mimic distortion into the three middle of them probably did a lot of damage, and of course the Malphite doing his ultimate as well. Overall, this went very well. The Wombo combo was quite real, and I'm quite happy about it. Hello there, Yasuo. How are you doing this fine afternoon? This concerns me, I'm not gonna lie to you. And the wind wall was still up. I thought I was gonna be done by then. I should leave. This is not worth. I want revenge, I want to kill this Yasuo, but I don't think it's going to be happening. But don't worry, we will come back and we'll get vengeance once again, even if we've already killed him before. Oh, Jesus! Oh, stay away from me, you gosh dang maniac. I don't want anything to do with no flippin' pirates. No, you don't understand, Gameplank. You do not understand. This is, you know, a life. Oh, jeez! Alright, yeah. I'm a bit worried Bard was gonna kill me there. Thankfully it didn't happen. But I won't lie, I was worried. I was worried the Bard was gonna be the end of my existence. Thankfully, we're all good. Just used my distortion in a place to where I would be fine. Didn't want to do it that way, because that might have been the end of my life. So that will be that. Diana trying to make some things happen. Not gonna be very successful. They are winning in terms of the, you know, neutral objectives, but I'm gonna go on a limb and say it's probably not helping them all that much. Just going to get an Amplifying Tome, working on a Rabadon's decks. If we can actually finish it, it's very possible we won't, but, you know, that's just the life you live when you look at LeBlanc and the way she works and the way she works the Black Rose. She resurrected Scion. Did you know that? Well, I didn't either. I just know she works for an organization that resurrected Scion. Part of some Hextech group, maybe, that Hextech Technology. Listen, they don't really explain the lore of Hextech Technology, so I can't really provide much feedback on the resurrection of science. Sorry if you, you know, so maybe you should just stop asking once in a while and leave me alone to my thoughts as I ponder how they resurrected science. No one asked how I resurrected science. I know this very well. And what the heck, I'll just push bottom lane. They're probably dead, but I don't think I'm going to be able to get there quick enough, so I apologize, team, but instead I'm just going to try to at least get something down here. Obviously, LeBlanc is the best split pusher in the world, but, you know, all of them are top, and I don't really know what to do when all of them are top, so Bard's just getting out of there. He actually went for Banner Command because he knows he's the true leader here. Alright, so probably won't be able to do a whole lot of damage in this turret here. I do see a Diana en route. Do some damage there. I know your Zonius is up. Oh, I should have put the Ignite on her. I thought that was going to do enough damage. I always hate when I do that, when I just don't put an Ignite off when it easily could have let me get a kill. Like, that's pretty bad. We'll put a little bit of a distortion right there, and then a chain, ethereal chain, and vanish. Okay, well, now that you've escaped me, Diana, we need to show you who's boss. But, oh, jeez. All right. They had vision there. Let's just immediately bail. Thankfully, I have decent reaction time, and don't even think about chasing me, you big little wind monster. Yeah, that's right. I called him monster. I know he's human very well, but that's not going to let him get the game respect for me to call him human. I would sell my Doran's Ring, but I'd rather wait to sell it. Math is difficult. I'm going to wait to sell it for an Isildur Rod instead if the time arrives. Otherwise, I'm just going to keep it. Mainly because even though it's a very little amount, that health may just save me. You never know. Some might say I'm a silly Billy, but I disagree. I am a silly Jimmy. I don't know where I was going with that, as per usual. Okay, there's a Gameplank located in the bottom lane. Also, shifty things going on over there. Bard looks like he's in a little bit of a situation. I'm going to try to help him, but I don't know if I'm going to be able to assist him quick enough. Let's go and put the Ethereal Chains and maybe get a kill. That's going to be the Ignite, and that'll be the kill. The ignite was probably unnecessary, but that's okay. Trundle, hard counter to Kha'Zix. I can see that. I can definitely see that. I also see very low people in the top lane, but they are very likely gonna not be there by the time I actually arrive. There's the Trundle. What's Trundle's items look like? He still has no MR. He probably saw me. Yeah, hello. Hello. Let's just go ahead and see how much damage we can do. Ah, it wasn't enough. I'm dead. I'm dead. Well, I'm okay. I guess she didn't have another ultimate ready. Oh, she's still going though. All right. Didn't she ult me when I had the crescent thing on me though? I don't know. Unless she just did it two times very quickly consecutively, and I just didn't realize it. I mean, I'll take it. Don't get me wrong. I'll definitely take being alive, but you know, there we go. I mean, at least now we know we are definitely not able to burst down the Trundle. We kind of get him close, but to be fair, he wasn't even at full health, so also something to keep in mind. Ashe, in fact, pretty much all of them I can burst down fairly well. It's just a matter of getting all my stuff off, because of course one has Windwall, one has Oranges, and one has Zonias, and that and Miss Diana Oblivion also can't just flat out kill me. So that's a concern. What the heck is going on over here? I'm not happy about what's going on. I'd appreciate it if I maybe get a little bit of an explanation. There's the ethereal chains and... leave me alone. You're a gosh dang monster. Alright. Are you gonna go? Yeah, you're gonna keep going. Alright, that's fine by me. Let's put a ward right there. Oh, Matt's gonna be the end of Malphite's career. Hello there, good sir. Oh, no! Okay. Oh, wait, Gameplank is just kind of chilling the top lane. Okay, I messed up. I used my Q and forgot that would change my Mimic. That was just really not me thinking straight. Jeez, here I am saying we're probably gonna win, and now we're very, very quickly throwing. Oh, the inhibitor. The inhibitor was barely saved. Okay, we need to group. We need to group before this turns into a throw. We should group as five. We should group as five, I think. Unless Gameplank arrives or just continues pushing in the top lane, but I feel like he shouldn't be too big of a deal if we're like in the Baron area. So, you know, that's something to keep in mind. Or fight them there, alright. If Malphite can get a good ult off, and, you know, Vayne can kind of chill in the back, we should build relatively easily. I mean, I'm fed, Kha'Zix is fed, Vayne's fed, we shouldn't be able to lose this, but the opportunity is quickly slipping from our grasp. That's an Ash arrow that's going to be hitting the Bard, so we know that's gone. That gives us more reason to, you know, gives us more reason to actually get it. Okay. Are we going to do the Baron? I feel like now would be a good time to do the Baron. Not sure if I'm entirely right there, but I just feel like now's a decent time to do the Baron. Do some damage to you there. Okay. Am I dead? Do as much damage as I can. Why wouldn't my Mimic go off? Wait. What the heck is going on? We won anyway. Okay. So my distortion did go off. I guess. Well, they're all dead. I'm taking credit for it. Good job, LeBlanc. You're the best trickster we all knew. I guess it helped that they spent so much, that a lot of their attention was probably divided to me being Zonyas'd. And I think Diane used her ultimate on me without having a crescent strike on someone else, so the cooldown was unleashed already. The vocabulary I use for some things. her unleashed, no, stop. Well, we won. Bit of a sloppy game by me, honestly. I'm clearly by no means an expert LeBlanc, but we still made some pretty decent plays, and I mean, we still got fed at the end of the day, so it's not that bad. I'm rusty, but that's okay. That will not stop me from showing off the rust and letting you take this rust and dissect it and call me a nerd. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure you like, comment, anything fantastic to say. I'll be sure to read and subscribe if you haven't already. Leaves a warm, fuzzy feeling in my heart. Have a great day.